was just about to say.
Oh, but he landed. Caught it. Big right hand. And he's taken to the mat straight away, which is exactly where Boggy wants to be.
Oh, that was beautiful. Boggy caught him with that right hand, transitioned into the takedown, and now Kong is on his back. This is not where he wants to be against Boggy.
I was just about to say the same thing, Mitch. Kong was floating around, looked very buoyant and bouncy, but then he just got caught, flushed, didn't he? And now it's a completely different ballgame.
That's that game-changing power of the heavyweight, Steve. You never know where it's going to come from. And they touch you on the chin, you're going to fall. Now Kong's in full guard now. He's got one butterfly hook. Let's see what he can do off his back here.
Here comes the ground and pound that we spoke about earlier on. This is how Boggy likes to finish when he's got his opponent down.
Now he's in half guard. You got to see Kong turn onto his side. He's got to get off of having both shoulder blades on the mat like that. But see how Boggy's controlling his right arm and not letting him get up? That's high-level grappling right there.
A lot of punishment, Mitch. Forearms and fists coming down. He's also pressing that face in with the open palm of his hand to make sure that he gets the proper target on the face, that he connects the way he wants to. Forearms again, elbows coming down.
Oh, he had full mount, but Kong did a huge bridge to get back up to his feet.
So well, and to come back with a left hand as well, but he goes straight for the single leg once more. It's going to be a relentless attack from Boggy to try and take it downstairs.
That was a nice little sprawl thrown by Kong to work his way back up to his feet. Nice little front kick to the body, digging the toes into the stomach of Boggy.
It's a sharp connection, isn't it, when the toes or the very base just underneath the toes makes connection with the ribcage.
This is what Boggy needs to do. He needs to slow down that attack. You can see that Kong was starting to time that takedown and sprawl very heavy and getting away from it. Boggy did a good job of pressing him up against the circle wall now. And let's see if he can slow down that movement of Kong.
Feels like there's nowhere for Kong to go with a man of Boggy's size just pressing him, hinging up against that wall. But he spins round or gets spun round and drips.
Yeah, he's just relentless with those takedowns. Once he gets a hold of that single leg, he'll keep trying for it. And it looked like Kong was going to be able to maintain his balance. But Boggy just kept working and eventually gets Kong down.
That looks like a guillotine, but he's going to slip out.
To finish.
Did just have that left arm around the back of the neck there. Never looked as if it was going to be taken to another stage, though, Mitch.
Easily passed from half guard into side control, steps over into mount. Look at that. That is just a shark in the water on the ground from Mehdi Boggy as he's now in mount.
This to finish.
Expect Kong to try to bridge out. Yep, there he goes, and he does it again.
That's big strength. That's really big strength. And now Boggy with his back.
That was a beautiful big bridge right there from Kong. Now he's on top, dropping the elbows of his own now.
What can Kong do with some ground and pound? He's also going for forearms, but certainly making connection with that glove. And he likes that forearm to the forehead, doesn't he? Breathing heavily, Boggy, by the way. You can hear it and see it.
You can just see the difference between Boggy on the top versus Boggy on the bottom. On the bottom, he's just trying to hold Kong, not really trying to go anywhere. But when he's on top, he's able to transition and float and drop ground and pound. Now Kong's moving into the full mount. And all Boggy can do is hold on. He's got to let go and start pushing away and create that space.
Kong was using the heel of his hand there just to vary the connection to Boggy's head. But again, he's coming in with the forearms and some elbows as well. And now we've really switched around because it's Boggy who's taking the meat of the punishment here. And he's drawn blood. The hammer blow from outside in.
20 seconds, Steve. Can he get it done in the round one?
15 seconds. Yuji Shimada is looking carefully. There's nothing coming back from Boggy, and he stopped it. He stopped it with just a few seconds left. It was a question of how much was coming back from Boggy, and it wasn't enough to satisfy Yuji Shimada that they should go to the end of the round. Big, big win for Kong, who at one point looked as if he may well be on the losing end of things.
Kong Ji-won maintains his 100% finishing rate and another knockout finish in the very first round, ladies and gentlemen. Somebody's knocking on the door in the heavyweight division. Actually, Kong Ji-won.
I know that Brandevira will be watching this, sizing up his potential opponents, and he'll be doing a little bit more reading on Kang Joo-won. Just take us through these highlights from that really enthralling first fight.
Oh, he suffers through some adversity. Look at this. Betty Boggy is all over him, dropping the ground and pound, putting a beat on him. But then Kang Joo-won turns the tables, ends up on top, starts letting the ground and pound go. And with just mere seconds left, referee jumps in, stops the
battle. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Kang Joo-won.
Fabulous work by our cameraman and our editors there. You can see in the replay that Kang managed to open up his opponent with a very sharp elbow to the center of the forehead. And as you can see, he's got a little wound in a very similar place.